Donnie and Dolly. The team is supported by AbleAuctions.ca. Closing your business? We can help.
I thought you'd be playing Notorious B.I.G., Ryan.
Yeah, more money.
Didn't happen. It is Wednesday. All of our guests today brought to you by Able Auctions, AbleAuctions.ca. Before we get to John Shannon, Delaney's okay, Tyron Langley inbox. Jap Joe again. Wait a minute, Ryan. Don't you go across the border to save money on gas and cheese. Rick, you as well.
Why would you do that?
Aren't you happy with your cheese and gas?
I'm frugal.
In Canada?
I'm frugal. You're greedy.
No, I'm loyal to my country.
No, but you act like Americans don't come up here across the border and go to Whistler.
Not to the same volume.
Give me a break.
No, it's
they're allowed to come over, and we're allowed to go. I go to Bellis Fair once in a while. What's the big deal?
To save money.
Yeah, and gas up and you know,
yeah.
Stuff like that.
Okay, let's bring in John, NHL analyst, co-host of the Bob McCowan podcast. He knows a thing or two about our industry, broadcasting. John, thanks for doing this, sir. How are you?
I am great, boys. 48 hours after the hangover, I'm doing okay.
Yeah. A lot of people, it's, you know, mixed feelings in Vancouver. They're out of the playoffs, but I think most people would agree it was a solid season. What about yourself? How would you describe the season the Canucks went through?
I think it's a classic case of under-promising and over-delivering. And I think there's a lot of people around the National Hockey League that have teams that don't get as far as the Canucks do and are saying, why can't our team do what the Canucks did? Why can't we do that? That to me is a big part of this, is their success is being reflected around the NHL saying, Jim Rutherford and Patrick Alvin have rebuilt this team with Rick Tocchet as the coach a lot quicker than most people realized.
Who do you give most of the credit to? Rick Tocchet said it's all about the players, which you'd expect from him.
Well, I think buy-in by the players was really important. I think you guys, you know, are close enough to the organization to know that many times there were, you know, 20 players pulling the rope 20 different directions. And it just so happens, it appears, that what they've been able to create is one group pulling in the same direction. And the players had to buy in. And I do think and you know what, Rick Tocchet's being modest, but in the end, the vision of Jim Rutherford on how to turn an organization around deserves a ton of credit. And Rutherford has his issues. He had issues with all of us and the fans and the players and ownership, but he stuck to his guns. And so if you're going to give one person credit, I think it's probably Jim Rutherford who deserves the credit for righting the ship and putting the right people in the right place.
All right, John, the Canucks took the Edmonton Oilers to Game 7. What are the Stars going to do to them? What's going to happen in that Western Conference Final?
Well, it's interesting. You know, in many ways, Rick, we watched JT Miller try to neutralize Connor McDavid. Well, I'm not sure that that there's a centerman on the Dallas Stars that can do similar to what Miller did. And so the onus is going to be on Chris Tanev, who's, I don't have to tell people in Vancouver what a warrior he is, Miro Heiskanen, who can skate almost as well as Connor McDavid. So I think it's going to be a different approach for Peter DeBoer's team. I think Dallas is a deeper team than Edmonton is. I think Edmonton has the two best players. And so to me, the balance of this will be decided Stuart Skinner versus Jake Oettinger. And if Skinner can match Oettinger, then Edmonton has a chance. But I think right now you have to give the odd to Jake Oettinger and the Dallas Stars.
John, you know, watching Craig Berube's press conference, he said all the things all new coaches say, accountability, communication, work ethic, we're going to be a team, no individuals, and same thing, every new coach says it. What were your thoughts on the news conference, and what kind of impact could Berube have in Toronto?
Well, you have a press conference and you try not to make any mistakes.
Right.
And try not to have fodder for the media and for the fans. And that's what they did in Toronto. And Craig Berube spoke Craig Berube style. And I think that that's something that people in Toronto are looking forward to. Make no mistake about it. And this is the Vancouver influence in Toronto. people here are not happy with the organization. People here want change in order to win. And so this is the first step in having some of that change. And I don't even know whether they can make change the way the fans want it. You know, the fans expect turnover on the roster. Craig Berube might be one of those guys that says, well, I don't want change on the roster. I want those big four back because I can make them better. And so I think that's going to be the interesting discussion all summer long with the Maple Leafs is what can Brad Treliving do to appease the fans and also give Craig Berube the best opportunity to win.
What's the future for Mitch Marner, John, in Toronto?
Well, you know, if the week after the playoffs ended for Toronto, it would be that he was persona non grata here. I think as the summer goes on, I think it will mellow. I think because, first of all, he's going into the last year of his deal. We don't understand and know yet whether the Maple Leafs want to extend him, even though he says he wants to stay. But does his continuing appearance in the Maple Leaf roster give this team the best chance to win? And I don't know that answer right now, and I don't think anybody does. But if you put him on the open market, if you give a team a chance to sign Marner and then trade for some quality defensemen, does that make this hockey team better? And I think there's lots of people inside the organization that think that. And that's the real challenge of what's going on in Toronto right now.
John, NHL playoff ratings are up fairly significantly in the States. Is there a clear reason for that?
I think it's the same reason why they're up in Canada. I think the matchups have been so good. Mm-hmm. I think that we had a great March and early April with playoff races. And then the 16 teams, actually that's not fair, the 15 teams plus the Washington Capitals that got in the playoffs are so competitively balanced. You know, this is a playoff like I can't remember, Donnie, where if you said, this series is going six or seven, there's nobody suggesting there's going to be a sweep or a five-game series. We've got to the Final Four with four teams that could all win the Stanley Cup. There isn't a fluke. Remember the old days of just get in and win? No, these are great teams. There are six great teams in the West. There were six great teams in the East. And I think that that's one of the reasons why the ratings are up is because people understand the competitive nature of what the playoffs are like and the teams that are playing them.
Yeah, this is the first time in a long time that I can remember the second round. This is my opinion, and I think a lot of people share it, that I thought the second round was more entertaining and interesting than the first round. Usually it's the other way around. Would you agree with that?
I would. I think that we were all surprised how competitive the second round was because usually there's a letdown. And by the way, there's usually a letdown in the third round too. Mm. And I don't see a letdown in Florida versus the Rangers and Dallas versus Edmonton. I think we have two heavyweight matches going on east and west.
How much do you think the NHL behind closed doors would love to see the Rangers make the Stanley Cup final?
A little bit. Okay. Not as much as you think. Okay. Not as much as you think. I think that they're probably happier. Nobody will admit this. They're probably happier that the Knicks are out.
Yeah,
and right. So the Rangers have the stage to themselves in New York, but the TV market in New York isn't as big as everybody imagines it, even on a local level. I think of the seven Canadian teams, I think five TV markets, in other words, the amount of viewers every game has in Canada is larger than New York, there's 17 million people in New York.
Yeah. Knicks and Rangers both made their respective finals back in 94. Infamously here in Vancouver, John. A little fact for you.
I recall. Those anti-Knick fans in Vancouver were terrible, weren't they?
Yeah. Just awful. Of course, remember one of the games, of course, interrupted by the OJ chase.
But
that's a story for another day. John, thanks for this.
Cheers, boys.